हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू अरिहंत इंग्लिश मीडियम स्कूल सोलापुर ऑनलाइन टीचिंग सेशन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न लेसन नंबर फर्स्ट ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 6 सब्जेक्ट जनरल साइंस। द नेम ऑफ द लेसन इज नेचुरल रिसोर्सेस एयर वाटर एंड लैंड। Observe the picture alongside and answer the questions. Where do we see the birds? Where is the cow grazing? Locate the trees and the road. Where does the river come from? How does it flow? Where is the aeroplane? Where are the fish seen? On what is the sailboat floating? You can see that some things in the picture are in water, some on land, and some in the sky, that is in the air. Thus, all things on the earth are associated with air, water, and land. Air, water and land are called the earth's atmosphere, hydrosphere and lithosphere respectively. Moreover, different living things occupy these three spheres of the earth. Now, biosphere. These living things and the part of the lithosphere, hydrosphere and the atmosphere which they occupy are together called the biosphere. These spheres have formed on the earth naturally, that is natural resources. What is meant by natural resources? The elements available in the nature that fulfill the basic needs of the living things on earth are called natural resources. So air, water and land are important natural resources. So we will see it by in detail. So first one is air. The atmosphere is the layer of air that surrounds the earth. The surface of the earth comprises water and land, that is the hydrosphere and lithosphere. So air, the air in the atmosphere around the earth contains nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, 6 inert gases, nitrogen dioxide, sulfur dioxide, water vapor and dust particle. Now in figure, the proportion of the various gases in the air is shown. That is, nitrogen is 78%, oxygen is 28% and all others are in given. Now the uses of gases in air. Nitrogen help us things to build the necessary proteins. It is useful in the production of ammonia and airtight packaging of foodstuff. Airtight packaging means which is the Lay's, Kurkure's. These are foodstuff which is airtight package. Okay. Oxygen necessary for respiration in living things and for combustion. Combustion means burning. Carbon dioxide, plants use it for producing their food, used in fire extinguishers. That is, in red color tube is there, in hospitals, in schools and big industries, the fire extinguishers are used. In that, carbon dioxide is used. Argon, used in electric bulbs. Helium, used for obtaining low temperature and also for generating the lift in airship. Neon, used in decorative lights and for street lights. Krypton, used in fluorescent tubes. Xenon, used in flash photography. What is the similarity in the three pictures below? All the three pictures, above pictures, show large scale emission of smoke through different agencies. This smoke directly mix with the atmosphere in our surrounding, that disturbing the balance between the constituent of air, that is the balance of the air constituents, that is nitrogen is 78%, oxygen is 20%, that is unbalanced because of the emission of this smoke. So this is called air pollution. Harmful gases are given out through combustion of fuels, that is burning of fuel in vehicles and big industries, and also through incomplete combustion of fuels like wood and coal. As a result, air pollution is increasing day by day. Harmful substances released in air through combustion of fuel, which are that? Nitrogen dioxide, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide and soot. Now next point is important, that is ozone layer, that is the protective shell, or it is a protective umbrella of our earth. There is a layer of ozone, that is O3 gas, in the lower part of stratosphere. See in figure. Ozone gas is not directly useful for the survival of living things. It is very important for living things to have this layer of ozone at a high altitude around the earth. The ultraviolet rays coming from the sun are very harmful for living things. So the ozone gas absorbs these rays. As a result, life on earth is protected. Ozone layer is destroyed if chemical gases like carbon tetrachloride or the chlorofluorocarbons carbons used in air conditioners and refrigerators mix with the air. Because of these gases, this ozone layer is destroyed, that is decreasing. So the 16th of September is celebrated as Ozone Protection Day all over the world to make everyone aware of the importance of ozone.